Well, good evening and welcome to the Furneaux Center for the Central Christian College of the Bible. Saints are getting ready to take on the Providence University College Pilots. The Pilots come all the way from Otterburn, Manitoba. Yes, you heard us right. That is an international basketball game that we are playing tonight. Brian Taylor on the mic with Bill Thomas.
Good to see you, Brian. Good to see you.
Welcome aboard, Bill.
Thanks for letting me be here.
The Pilots start with the ball tonight and have the first turnover of the evening.
Looks like they're going to press.
Pilots come out in a full court press here. Getting the ball to their ball handlers up front here. Ball still getting worked around, gets across the timeline, and they get the ball down to Wisenhunt. She puts the ball up, no good. Pilots rebound, come back. And we're seeing on the sideline here a strategy put in by the coach here to rotate players in and out. He's already got five up to rotate in and out there, Bill. That's not even a minute to go in the game.
You don't see that a lot. Five players in right away.
Wisenhunt. Wisenhunt up for her second shot tonight. Ofer on that. Deep three. On the transition, rebound by the other Wisenhunt. Gets the ball to Faith Owen. She's going to bring it up across the timeline. Wisenhunt from the corner. Teams are starting off here a little cold, Bill.
They are. There's a bucket by the Pilots on a fast break.
That would be number three, Abigail Medzutski.
Press is still on. The Saints seem to be having no trouble breaking it, though.
Rhea Brady lucky to not get called there.
Nice shot, Macy.
Macy Wisenhunt ties it up.
Saints are playing a zone, Brian. Looks like they're daring them to shoot outside.
Yeah, Coach Corey's been testing. One of her favorite MOs is to test their ability to hit from outside. Yeah, we got a. Let me take your knee out foul there on number three, Abigail Medzutski.
Here comes wave number two of the Pilots.
And we have a wholesale change there from the Pilots. Rhea Brady taking a seat there. Just recently discovered that Rhea is from the same town my father grew up in.
Huh. In Illinois, huh?
Calumet City.
Yep.
Southside Chicago.
Looks like Lexi's going to try to make a play inside.
Deep three. No good.
Shot clock winding down there. Pilots get an easy one on that drive.
Saints trail by two. 7 minutes to go here in this first quarter. Faith Owen with the ball. Gets it to Markaria Hines. Markaria on the drive. Kick out to Darling. Darling to Markaria.
Boy, the Pilots are playing a tough defense.
And Markaria. Hines for three.
Downtown.
Giving the Saints the first lead of the night, 5-4.
That's a three.
A bank three. I'm not sure the bank's open here.
I think
Friday afternoon. She did not call that, Bill.
She got the deposit.
She did. 5-7. Faith Owen with the ball on the right wing. Doing some driving, dribble drive. And she's
double teamed there.
Yep.
That's a shot right there, Kelsey Todd.
Kelsey Todd, one of the leading scorers for the Saints. Averaging double digits for the Saints this year.
Oh, ball's
Saints
on the floor.
Doing a good job. Good job fighting in there
ball's
by
going back to the Saints.
Rachel Darling, I believe, on that for the Saints.
Here comes a new wave of pilots.
It's an interesting substitution pattern.
They press all the time. Maybe they got to keep them fresh. Got a walk down here underneath, Brian.
Turnover by the Saints. They're tormenting us up here right now, Bill. We've got the popcorn machine going, and you can smell that.
I can smell the popcorn.
Taste buds here just salivate like crazy over there.
That is true.
A little buttered popcorn for the evening might be in order.
They throw him with the drive.
Gets the ball recovered here. Todd trying to make something there and
pilot send in four new players.
All right, got a timeout on the court. So, Bill, tell us a little bit. You are the registrar here at Central. You've been here for a year. You come to us as we transition with St. Louis Christian College merging here with Central. How's this first year been for you?
Hey, it's been great. Been at Central since October, full time, and have enjoyed being here, have enjoyed everything that I get to do at the school, and this is a first-time opportunity to share this broadcast with you, so I'm excited to do that. But everything's going well. I think things are going great at CCCB, including the start of this basketball season for both the men and the women.
Yeah. We're coming in out of timeout here. 5:08 to go here in this first quarter. 7-7. And only one foul called thus far in the game, and it's been on the pilots.
Saints are still in a 2-3 zone.
And come out of the timeout, hitting a three-point shot.
A turnover. They called that a two, huh?
Had a foot on the line. Ooh. Kelsey Todd not keeping her hands on it.
It's like Wizenan's in for Faith Owen.
Shot put up by Claire Grisless. No good. Rebounded by the Saints. Macy Wisenan on the rebound. Macaria Hines on the drive. And going to get called for the turnover.
Looks
there.
Like she might have taken an extra step.
I think she dragged the back foot there on that stop. But what happens when you don't do that classic two-foot jump stop,
you always have the
chance of dragging your foot a little bit with momentum.
That's a long three.
It is a long three. Kelsey Todd on the rebound doing a great job, and she is in and amongst the trees and fighting hard there.
She wanted that rebound.
She got that over the 6-foot Emma Wiebe from Brandon, Manitoba. Macy Wisenan getting it up to the sister. Lexi with the shot. No good. Rebound Wisenan. And
she got fouled.
It's just a little Wisenan basketball
it
out there,
is.
Bill.
It's just like in their driveway at Higbee.
First first one is up and good for Macy.
Looked really good on that free throw.
Macy Wisenan, a 5'3 guard from Higbee, Missouri.
Freshman.
In her first year, that's right.
We got a violation on that one. We're going to shoot that again.
Second one up and good. Ties things up again. 9-9. Rhea Brady on the rebound.
Not hesitating to take those threes. Hard fall.
Kelsey Todd breaking ankles out there. Ball into Ray. They got a 3-on-1 there on that backside. And Wisenan in there fighting. That's Macy Wisenan in there fighting for that rebound.
That one's going to go to the Saints.
Saints will keep the ball. Five new players come in.
Lined up four across.
Ill-advised toss in there. Just out of habit, it looked like throwing a ball rather than looking for the open person, and it's a turnover on the Saints.
Pilots going the other way.
Rhea Brady on the rebound. Rhea has that habit of just swinging the ball around after a rebound, and she's either going to clock somebody one of these times or can be prone for turnovers on that.
She's tough in there, but referee thought she moved her feet and her elbows.
We got a little ping pong going on. Saints going to end up with the ball. Kelsey Todd going to inbound it.
Pilots are still pressing.
Kelsey Todd looking up. Good, easy bucket for the Saints. Way to break the press.
Good pass and basket.
Dribbling with her head up, makes an easy pass. Easy bucket for the Saints, 11-9. And ball off Lexi Wisenan. You can press this kind of basketball if you've got 14, 15 players you feel comfortable rotating in and out. And I can't blame them as a strategy. They're on a three-game road trip here from Manitoba over to they played at Crown College last night in Minnesota.
Mm-hmm.
They're here tonight, and then they are at Calvary tomorrow. Mm. So three nights, back-to-back games.
Back-to-back is tough, and they press, so they need all 14 players.
Faith Owen gets the ball into Kelsey Todd and up to Wisenan, and Wisenan to Wisenan for back-to-back buckets and a bonus shot.
And one. Wisenan to Wisenan.
Saints doing a good job of reversing the basketball on that press. And in doing so, they catch the Pilots out of position. And with one pass, the last two possessions, they're able to get layups. So
the Saints have found the open player both times, last two trips down, breaking that press.
And that's how you get them out of a press, is you make easy buckets. And Lexi gets the roll.
Rolled around and dropped. Oh, I thought she traveled, and so did the ref.
Oof. Faith Owen up. Gets the ball to Kelsey Todd, breaking the press. Bringing it into the center of the lane. Good control on the dribble.
Wisenan's
warming up. See, watch out when Lexi gets going.
She's on fire.
16-12, Saints lead.
That's a two. Oh.
Akaria.
Smallest with player the possession, on the floor.
Gets the ball to Faith Owen. And Kelsey Todd going to pick up the foul.
I think she was.
I mean, the foul's going to be.
She was fouled.
Fouled, yes. Was stating that in the reverse way. That's the fourth personal, fourth team foul. That's first foul called on Hayden Wiebe, center, 6'6 center out of Winkler, Manitoba.
They're going to say she was shooting.
Kelsey Todd going to the line for two. A little strong on that shot.
Round and round it goes.
Had to do a couple round-the-world trips there before it decided to go in. For Kelsey Todd, her two free throws in, and Saints battling on the for the rebound, knock it out. Goes to the Pilots.
Watch for the three.
And they say the ball's out on the Pilots. Saints will get the rebound.
Under 2 minutes to go in the quarter.
Coach Corey Zarzewski's team this year doing a much better job handling pressure situations, particularly full court pressure situations. He's got a lot more ball handlers on the court this year, making the press something the Saints can handle much easier. Faith gets the ball to Makari Hines at the top of the key. Bounce pass inside. Rhea Brady gets it and up and no good. We got a knockout to Faith Owen. Faith on the dribble drive, no good. Rebound.
A lot of hustle Pilots. From the Saints on that one. Just couldn't Makari get the
out
ball
doing
in.
A good job stopping the ball, stopping the press. We're going to have a body check for the first team foul called on the Saints tonight in this first quarter.
And
it's going to be called on number 14.
A new wave of Pilots coming in. Ball under the basket.
First personal for Markaria Hines. Markaria read that one well, knocked the ball out.
She about had that one stolen.
She saw it. Saints doubling up. Ooh, they should have. Ooh, that was a jump ball.
Wanted a tie up there.
Yep. Ooh. Rhea Brady on the block.
Playing tough.
And the rebound.
Playing tough in the middle.
Getting the ball out to Faith Owens. Faith. Getting across the timeline, doing a great job handling the ball. She got bumped there a little bit. Makari on the drive.
Lost that one out.
Be just a turnover.
Under a minute to go in the quarter. Saints have handled that press pretty well today.
They have. They have. The Saints was the press was the real challenging point last year for these ladies, and right now they're doing a great job of handling it.
Well,
it
looks like
Wisen in on the hustle, and
that's going to go to the Pilots.
Yep, ball stays with the Pilots. Shelby Kennemore checking in for the Saints.
It's a long three.
And it's good.
She splashed that
cutting
one down.
The lead to two.
30 seconds in the quarter. Got to get the ball in.
Ball into Rhea Brady, and then Faith Owens bringing it across the half-court line, avoiding the double team.
She's got a
great job to drive it in. No good.
Rachel was hustling that time, just got called for the foul on the back.
Foul there on, I believe that's Rachel Darling, her first. Saints third. And Raya Brady.
Yeah, Raya knocked that one out of the
Looked
lane.
Looked like she was playing volleyball there.
She spiked that one right out of the lane. 4 seconds to go for the Pilots.
Oh. And they get the bucket to tie it up at the end of this first quarter.
Looks like we were looking for the three, and they surprised us shooting that little two.
Saints are tied with the Pilots from Providence University College in Otterburn, Manitoba here tonight at the end of the first quarter, 17-17. We're going to take a short break here. You're watching Saints basketball from Central Christian College of the Bible.
Whenever I hear it.
And we're back after break, quarter break.
It's a good game, Brian, 17-all. Saints have the ball. McCurry Hines to Faith Owen. Faith got a lane.
Oh, on the backside, Macy or Lexi Mister.
Yeah. Macaria over there to Shelby Kinnamore. Shelby to Rachel. That's two.
Two.
Off the backboard.
Rachel Darling with her first points of the night. Rachel's a freshman from Kirksville, Missouri.
Nice move for the Pilots in the middle, tying it back up.
I think we're in for a good game tonight. Shelby Kinnamore, there we go. Opening herself up to get the ball.
Oh.
And got a turnover. A little pressure got to her a little bit.
Yeah, it's the first turnover, though, on the press. That's only one.
Yep. Saints doing a good job on the defensive end here, just keeping them way outside.
Another long three.
And travel.
Looks like she took a trip in the lane.
Yeah, I didn't think it looked like a clean swipe by the Saints player there, so.
We got lots of people coming in.
I think Coach Corey's going to have to adopt the same philosophy here of keeping legs fresh by moving girls in and out, too. She just doesn't have as deep a bench.
We may be seeing the managers play before this game is over.
Kelsey Todd.
See, he got pushed back there.
Going
to
get
court.
Another, draw another foul here, so. That would be the first team foul on the Pilots, and first personal foul called on Trinity Blair. Macaria with a
tough pass there.
Yep, and then gonna pick up the foul as she tries to retreat to play defense. Be her
Pilots are in that
second
box. Yes,
personal
second
foul on Macaria. First team foul this quarter.
Last last time in this formation. They sprint out for the three and then dumped an easy one in the middle for a easy two.
Yeah, they're discussing the shot clock here and whether or not it needs to reset.
I think Coach Corey has an opinion.
And oh, good job, Kelsey Todd, being in, and the reach in foul.
Happens a lot.
That is such a common practice.
A play doesn't go when we get frustrated and make the foul.
The human condition, right, Bill? When you make a mistake, you want to make up for it, and it usually leads to some problems.
Yeah, doing more than you need to do.
Yep.
Been quite a few referee conferences tonight.
Yeah, we started the game off with one. This is the third kind of don't mind a team trying to make sure they get it right, though.
Yeah, he wanted to get the calls correct.
Let's see, Wiseman on the Rachel Darling up. No good. Macy.
Good board by Macy. Good board.
You know, those Wiseman sisters, for not being, you know, 6 foot, 6'2", 6'3", end up with a lot of rebounds.
They fight underneath, and they're tough.
They know, they've been taught, they've been trained, and they have a mentality that that ball is mine if it comes off the rim. So
free throw is spot on.
Macy back for a second free throw. Saints lead 20-19.
Got them both. Looks like the Saints are still in that 2-3.
Yeah, extending it out, trying to. Makari Hines on the rebound. Gets the ball to Kelsey Todd. Kelsey got stripped from behind.
And no. Saints got a break on that one.
There it is, another. Another mistake and another foul.
Another one of those. I think I got to make up for that, Moose.
Yep. And we got the wholesale change for the Pilots again. I don't know if I would like playing under that system. Might be a little hard to find a rhythm, and if you find a rhythm to be taken out of it, it would be a little, it'd be hard to play into that.
I'd agree. It's tough to find a shooting rhythm, but I do think they are able to press and run the whole time.
Yeah, I suppose you can condition for it and learn to play in that rhythm, but
again,
that full court press just causing all kinds of problems, Coach.
We got a timeout.
Coach Corey calls the K to say, or the timeout to save the possession. Probably a good move on her part. 21-19, 7:54.
Yeah, the arrow was going the Pilot's way that time, so it was a good call.
So we're going to just take a short break here. You're watching Saints basketball from Central Christian College of the Bible. Saints are back at it here. Saints ball the far end of the court. Got to get it across this.
You got a 10-second call.
It seemed awful quick.
It did to me, too. I wasn't the one counting, but it did seem quick.
We'll have to go back and watch the clock on that because our crack cameraman, Clayton LeCount over here, has the camera just high enough up to see the camera, so or see the clock. So we'll be able to
that's a long
view of that.
Oh, in and out.
Saints get the rebound. And they're ready to go right into their press. Good work by Faith Owen to
good
maneuver
pass
around it.
And then driving in the middle. Should have gone.
Saints hustling back on defense. And
clean
a good
block.
The Saints have to learn to do here is get that ball and get going and stop dancing around when they get a rebound. They're holding on way too much after getting a rebound.
Long three from Macy.
We're going to have a push on Makaria there.
That's going to be her, is it her second or third?
I believe that's her third.
That's her third.
Yep. Makaria Hines, third personal foul, team's third foul this quarter. three team fouls apiece here with not quite 3 minutes gone, just over 3 minutes gone in this quarter. Paying real close attention to the clockwork tonight.
They've done a good job so far on that, I think. All right.
We're going to have a traveling called on number 13. That's Jasmine Horwood, a guard out of Brandon, Manitoba.
Looks like she wanted to shoot, then decided not to.
Faith Owen into Rachel Darling.
Nice
Rachel
move.
Off the backboard.
Off the backboard. That's a good move to get that open look.
23-19. Deep three. I think there was a travel in there, Bill.
There was a lot of movement with no dribbling.
I think they're following my advice now. They're trying to get the ball and going, but just not being able to keep possession of it.
There's a lot of players crashing into each other, and we got a whistle.
Faith Owen on the hustle there is ball pass around, get to Rachel Todd on the baseline on the runner.
Kelsey Todd hits that one. Nice shot.
25-19.
That might be the Saints' biggest lead today.
Rhea Brady on the rebound. Set out to Kelsey Todd. Kelsey gets it up. Good.
That's going to go to Saints' way.
It's going to be the Saints' ball. That's correct. Saints do it. When they get the ball into the middle of the court on the press break, they put such great pressure on the people playing defense that almost always they have a three-on-two if they can get it there.
And they've done a pretty good job of that this afternoon.
Rhetorical questions being asked by the coach over there. And turnover, Kelsey Todd.
Another long three. That one found a home.
I believe that was by Kishi Riaferio, guard out of Estevan, Saskatchewan.
We had trouble with the press that time. In and out.
One of the things I'll give credit to the Pilots, they seem to always be moving.
They are hustling.
They move, they move, they move, they move.
And the Saints have done a good job of that tonight. They played hard this first half. They don't have as many players to bring in, but they have played hard.
Yeah, we got a shuffling of the feet. Feet look like a deck of cards there, Bill.
Well, they sure did shuffle.
In for the Saints right now, we've got Faith Owen, Macy Wisenan, Kelsey Todd, Rhea Brady, and Lexi Wisenan. Faith Owen bring the ball up for the Saints. And they're going to say that's an over and back call. Faith lost control, possession of that over the half court line.
Did that look touched to you? I thought it might have been touched.
Yeah.
Apparently it was not. Long three.
Another deep three. And we are tied up at 25. 4 minutes left to go here. Coach Corey calls a 30-second timeout.
I will say, Brian, the Pilot style of play, continual motion, sure puts a lot of pressure on the Saints to be able to keep up.
It's an interesting philosophy. If you can get 15 players and you can rotate three sets of five, which is, it seems like what they're doing pretty regularly, it does put a lot of pressure. It puts a lot of pressure on the conditioning of your team at the point in which you play them. So,
well, they're pressing. So every possession, the Saints are having to work to get the ball down. They're breaking it, but it is a lot of effort to break that press.
And over time, that can wear you down and create even more turnovers, which I'm going to guess is what they're banking on to a degree.
I think that's the Pilots' game plan, is to wear them down.
Part of their overall strategy. Ball to Rhea. Rhea over to Kelsey Todd.
He's got
Kelsey with the bank shot. No good. Rebound, Faith Owen. Faith on the dribble drive here. Kicks it out to Macy Wisenan just off the back of the rim. No good. Pilots with the rebound and the fast break. Move the ball down
way
fast.
Way outside. Another long one.
Another three. That's three three-pointers in a row for the Pilots from.
The Pilots are hot from the outside at the moment.
Providence. You ever been to Canada, Bill?
I have never been there, but I know that you have, Brian.
I spent a couple years over on the West Coast. I have visited Winnipeg at one time in my life. Have a good friend who lives in Winnipeg. Pretty incredible film director that I know over there.
Very good. Is that where the Pilots are from?
They're just south of Winnipeg.
Okay.
About, if we did it in miles, it'd probably be about 45 miles. I think it's about 60 kilometers.
That's a long way from there to Moberly, Missouri.
Yeah. Again, they've been on a three-day road trip here for 3 days of back-to-back games. But Faith Owen with the ball for the Saints at the top of the key. Cross-court pass to Wisenan on the dribble drive. She gets it knocked out.
A lot of contact underneath.
Yep. Deep three, no leg under that. No good. Rebound, though, by number 12. That would be Megan Wiebe, 5'7", guard from Vita, Manitoba. She's in Canada, they'd say she's a fourth year.
Fourth year.
Which would be, in America, a senior.
Senior. wave of players coming in for the Pilots. Macaria Hines coming in for the Saints. Macy Wisenin getting a rest.
Kind of a risky thing for a coach to put Macaria back in with her three
personal
fouls.
She's got three
fouls. Yeah.
Looks like Brady's coming back in as well. And Lexi's getting a break. The Wisenin sister's taking a break here.
Kelsey Todd up. First one good.
Good. I think Kelsey Todd would want you to know that she has new shoes tonight.
I noticed that tonight. I was asking her before the game.
She was showing those to me before the game as well.
Those were new kicks.
Yeah.
And hits them both. Saints now down by three, 27-30.
Long three.
Another deep three. Rhea Brady on the rebound. Gets the ball out to Todd. Todd dribbling it up. All the way from left side of the court to the right side of the court.
Yeah.
Passes the ball off to Macaria Hines. They are just doubling up wherever they can, those guards.
As soon as the ball goes down, they are
Rhea Brady, there. Though, on the pickup of the turnover.
Out to Todd.
Ooh. Active defense.
That
number seven.
That was good defense.
Trinity Blair.
That was good defense.
A third year out of Brandon, Manitoba, with the steal and the bucket. Kelsey Todd with the runner. No good, and we're going to.
They got a charge on Kelsey.
I think that's going to be, is that Kelsey?
They call that on, I don't know who they called that on, Brian.
Yeah. I thought it was on Rhea, but maybe not. Faith Owen on the rebound, and oh, there you go. A reach in there on Trinity Blair.
That'd be the fourth on the Pilots.
Fifth team foul, actually, on the Pilots.
Fifth.
That's the third foul on Blair. Faith up and good. Pulls the Saints within four with a minute 16 to go here in the second quarter. And off, but
nice
Rachel
rebound.
Darling with the handoff to Rhea Brady. Rhea Brady with the putback.
Nice, nice, nice play.
Saints now within two.
Look like we got a walk there.
Another travel.
It's a big possession coming up for the
Saints.
I
think they use the Euro step in Canada, Bill, which is causing them a lot of problems tonight.
That little half step before
they
dribble.
Yeah, that's right. So seems like they're getting caught an awful lot with that tonight here. Been the majority of their turnovers there for the Pilots. Macaria Hines trying to get into the middle, and three on one usually doesn't work well.
That just got poked away, as did that one.
Faith Owens on the great defense. That's going to get called for the reach in.
Saints are playing hard this afternoon against a team that constantly runs and presses.
That would be Faith Owen. That would be her first personal foul, team's fifth. And that's number five. Kishi Rioferio out of Estevan, Saskatchewan, getting two for the Pilots.
Saints are down four, less than a minute in the quarter.
Macaria Hines from deep
three. Nothing been there.
Hines for three. 33-34 with 33 seconds to go. Saints now.
And there's
another Euro step call.
There's your call again. I think they should have left that half step with them.
Yeah. Macaria Hines with the ball for the Saints. 30 seconds to go. Again, there a lot of reach in.
Yeah, we're going to get a call there. She's going to go to the free throw line.
I think we call that being handsy, Bill.
You got to play defense with your feet, not with your hands.
It's kind of funny. Out here on the court, you can get away with that. You do that in a workplace, you're going to visit human resources, right?
I've got no comment on that, Brian. No comment.
Either way, it's a foul.
Ooh, McCurry just rimmed out the first one.
33-34.
He's got one.
McCurry is
going to
get it tied up here with 26.1 seconds to go.
Brady with the good
rebound. Brady with the rebound and putback. So I was wrong. Great. Saints lead 35-34.
Great move by Ray. Shot clock is off.
They're having a hard time getting anything inside to work for them. So
they shoot outside almost every possession, except for that one.
We talked about it, and it happens. Kelsey Todd.
And we're at the half.
Boy, they could have called a foul on that, a shot attempt. But we're at halftime, Bill.
That we are. It's a good game.
35-36. Saints trailing by one.
I think both teams are probably happy to get to the half. And we'll see what the second half brings.
Undoubtedly, I think the Saints' legs need a little bit of a break here to recover, get for the second half. We'll be back with second half action. You're watching Saints basketball from Central Christian College of the Bible.
Comment, Brian. And that's what I said.
And welcome back to the Furneaux Center on the campus of Central Christian College of the Bible. We have the Saints tonight taking on the Providence University College Pilots out of Otterburn, Manitoba. That's right, you heard it, an international game here on the Central campus tonight. So, Bill, we played we played 20 minutes here in the first half. And the score is 35-36. What did you see that the Saints were doing exceptionally well here at the start of this game?
Well, Brian, they broke the press well. They handled the ball well. Not too many turnovers. That needs to continue in the second half. They got the ball inside quite a bit, especially off the break. If they continue that, they'll look pretty good at the end of this game.
Pilots start with the ball. Pilots are in the navy blue uniforms tonight. Saints in their gray uniforms. Their gray home uniforms. Saints start out in that 2-3 zone again.
Still in that 2-3. Good rebound by Macy Wisenin. Working hard down there.
Faith Owen taking it up the left side of the court. It's a ball to Kelsey Todd. Kelsey drives the baseline, kicks it up to Faith. Faith from deep three.
Long three.
She's got that range.
Yeah, nobody home that time.
Rebound by the Pilots. Get the ball up.
That's a long three.
Number 11. That would be Claire Grisless. 5'10", first-year student from Winnipeg.
And the Pilots are still pressing, Brian.
You know where Winnipeg is, don't you?
Winnipeg?
Yeah.
I think I do. You told me earlier.
Yeah, it's in Manitoba.
Manitoba. I remember the Winnipeg Gold Eyes baseball team.
All right.
We got some tussle going on out here before the ball comes in.
It's going to be a foul on number 10, Alex Patterson. 5'6" guard, first-year student out of Winnipeg. That's her fourth team personal foul. Makaria Hines driving into the center of the court. Pulls it back. Give it to Faith. Faith drives to the right. Kicks it to the corner to Kelsey Todd. Kelsey on the baseline drive.
Into Ray
over to
Brady.
Ray
Brady
good for
pass
the layup.
And two.
And it's good.
That's a good play right there, Brian.
Saints cut the lead to two.
Steal.
Makaria Hines on the defensive play. Saints are going to keep the ball on the Pilot turnover.
Only down by two.
Kari Hines in the corner. Faith Owen doing a good job. Makaria driving it up the right side. Getting the ball to Faith on the curl
she
route.
She had the lane, it looked like. That's a long three from Todd. Ooh.
Kick out to Todd. Rebound number
Faith
five on Kishi Rio Fierio.
I thought Faith had a lane that time.
She did. Faith has one of those Christian challenges, Bill. she's almost too selfless, which you love to see in out of our young people on campus, people that think about others first. But she's talented enough to be able to take a few more shots on her own. So
nice shot by Kelsey Todd from the wing.
Kelsey Todd on the bucket, 39-39. Rhea Brady.
Oh. And she said, get that out.
Rhea said, here you go. Let's see how you do with a hammer.
You earned those points. We're not giving those away.
That's Rhea Brady's first personal foul. Coach's going to set her down and let Rachel Darling come in.
Rachel's had a good game tonight.
Rachel in her first season for the Saints, freshman from Kirksville, Missouri. And at the line is number 14. That's Anna Cushon, Oxbow, Saskatchewan, 5'10", second-year student. She is missed them both.
Rims off, too.
And Wisenay gets the ball to Owen. Owen over to
that's a three.
Owen from
Nothing
the corner.
But net.
41-39.
You can only count that as a two.
Saints back on top. Rachel Darling.
Nice play by the Pilots in the middle.
Yeah, got a good post up there. Boy, they're just, they continue to be handsy up there.
They're relentless. They're relentless.
Let's just say that HR would be having all kinds of complaints if this were anything but a basketball game.
Oh, that's going to be a foul. That's going to be a foul. I can see that one from up here.
Rachel Darling getting hammered on her way to the hoop.
And five more Pilots come in as Rachel's at the foul line.
It was called on Amber Navarro, 5'2", first-year student out of Alberta, Calgary, Alberta. Alberta.
Rachel left that one a little short.
Left them both short.
Pilots coming back the other way.
Yeah, you got to travel on that for sure.
What is that, about the fourth or fifth call traveling on the Pilots?
Yeah, but that was not the Euro step, Bill. That was just ball control issues.
That was just a regular old travel.
Yeah. Mercari Hines.
Facing the press. They're trapping down here.
Yep. They just got to move to an open spot to give some passing lanes for the Saints.
If they're trapping, somebody's open. Kelsey Todd.
Kelsey Todd
nails
for the
three.
Coach Corey giving her approval on the movement to break the press.
Pilots are moving it around. That's a long three.
And well, Bill, you know what they call this?
They answer it back.
This is called the three fest.
That's a three fest. It is. And, oh, there's an out-of-bounds call.
Tough defensive play there by Trinity Blair on the point of that defensive press.
They trap every single time the ball comes in.
Yeah, it's not basketball for them, Bill, if they are not hitting the press.
There's the trap. Breaking it, though.
Kelsey Todd on the right-hand side for the Saints.
Driving in all the way. She got the foul. Looked like the Pilot did not agree. I don't know who that is, but she would beg to differ.
That would be number 14, Anna Kashan out of Oxbow. Saskatchewan.
Ray is coming back in. Rachel's taking the seat.
Kelsey Todd at the line. That's four team fouls on the Pilots. Kelsey Todd splits her first.
Nothing but net.
Second. Kelsey Todd finding a rhythm here.
Yeah, two for two. It's a good sign for the Saints.
46-44. Saints lead by two.
Well, that's going to go. Saints got a chance here. That ball's loose.
Playing a little pinball action. Going to have a reach in on Lexi Wisenan.
Scrambling for the ball. Working hard.
That's her first personal foul. Team's second this quarter. 5:47 left to play here in the third quarter.
Watch for a three breaking out of this. Long one. No one home this time, and the Saints will take it. Oh, we got a tip.
Now the outside referees called a touch on that shot, so ball stays with the Pilots.
They were a little closer than we are, Brian.
They're going to have a reach-in foul, but boy, she looked like she lost control of it. That's going to be the fourth team foul, I believe, on the Saints. Faith Owens' second personal foul.
Ball's coming out. Same play and the same result.
And they call back-to-back fouls on Faith Owen. Her third personal foul, team's fourth. Faith with the steal, though.
Yeah, she held that too long, and Faith picked her pocket.
And their pesky little handsy guards up there are giving Faith a good dribbling workout, but the girl can handle the ball. She's got handles, I think, Bill, is what they say, the young kids these days. She's got handles.
Handles, huh?
Yeah.
Well, she can definitely handle the basketball, and the Saints are wise to get it to her, bringing down that press.
Saints to the line in the bonus here. Faith to the line to shoot 1-1. Nope, sorry, to shoot two.
Yeah, looks like they're in the bonus already. She gets one out of two. Macy's coming in, giving Faith a break.
All right, 47-44. Saints with a three-point lead here with 5:19 left to go in this third quarter.
It's a pretty high-scoring game for.
Yeah, we still have a quarter and a half left to go, Bill, and we're at the almost at the 50-point mark.
Almost at the half-century mark.
It was because of all the threes that were raining here in the third quarter.
It was flooding threes.
Yes.
Look for Kelsey Todd to be bringing this down, or Makaria Hines.
Makaria gets past the initial press, doing a good job of. This handsy tendency of our Canadian team here might get them in trouble tonight.
Well, apparently the officials decided at halftime they're going to call it tighter.
Yep.
We've had a lot more whistles in this third quarter than we had earlier.
Yeah, we're looking at Makaria Hines the line to shoot.
She's going to be shooting
in the double
two.
Bonus.
And a friendly bounce.
That gets the shooter's roll.
It's like the Providence coach is looking for some explanation.
Yep.
That's two.
49-44, 5 minutes to go. Deep three.
And over the top. Macy Wisenin to Rhea Brady.
Brady, be careful of the half-court line. There we go.
That's
two Macy.
Two.
And that's going to be short. And
looks like we got a foul going against the Saints.
Darling's going to be called for the push foul on the rebound.
And the Pilots bring in a new wave.
I wonder if the coach's name by chance is Katrina. Because we could call him the Katrina and the Waves, which I think is an 80s band, is it not, Bill?
That's a good one, Brad. I like that one. Katrina and the Waves. Long three. Nobody there.
Wisnan saves it to the Pilots.
That's going to be your travel.
That's Euro step.
Yep.
Yeah, they have a hard time getting that foot. Referees conversing there underneath the hoop. Substitution, Faith Owens comes in. Rachel Darling goes out.
Lexi Wisenin's back in, I think. We got something going to happen here. Both teams are going to the bench.
I think there's a timeout called. No, don't touch it. That's fine. I think That's a referees conferencing here. Might be an unofficial timeout.
What do you think they're discussing here, Brian? What do you think?
I think they're discussing what they're going to do for dinner afterwards, Bill.
Maybe so.
I mean,
that
this,
could be.
This time of the game, they've been working through dinner, and I'm thinking they're discussing the options that they have here in Moberly for
that could be
for something to eat. It could be you know, something down the road, a little Mexican restaurant. Got a few of those here
in
town.
Good one.
They might be discussing the Chinese buffet in town as well. Who
knows?
That's
possible. That's all possible.
Yep. Or I know it's probably not open, and this is probably their real disappointment, is the Bubba's Burger Emporium is only open over the lunch hour.
Now, I have never heard of Bubba's Burger Emporium.
Yeah, well.
Good place?
Yes.
You executive team guys must get to go there. Us lower level folks don't get to go there very often.
Bill, you could go there.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah. It does not take an executive salary or anything to eat at the Burger Emporium.
At Bubba's Burger Emporium. Are they sponsoring this broadcast?
They're not sponsoring this broadcast.
We've given them
a little bit of promo, yeah. Yeah, I don't know. This is there's a lot of conversation taking place with the head coach there from
Providence
University.
That head coach is a pretty tall guy.
Yeah.
I believe he's played, don't you think?
So the ball is going
going back to Providence.
Providence.
Not sure what happened there.
Nope.
No, it's not
going to.
It's
going to be
Saints
ball.
And the Providence coach is on the court. He seems satisfied with the explanation, though.
Okay. Back to action here in the third quarter. 4:26 to go. Saints have the ball. Lexi Wiseman bringing it up the court. Gets the ball out to Rhea Brady. The left-handed Rhea gets it to Faith Owen.
She's in three-point range there. Looked like she thought about it.
A good
drive by
good,
Todd.
Good.
And a bucket.
Good screen there by Lexi.
Yeah, nice play. That was a good
51-44.
Good drive.
Saints leading.
I think might be matching the Saints' largest lead. Oh, clean block.
Rhea on the block.
Rhea's going to drive and take it herself. Oh.
Got a 3-second call on Lexi Wiseman down.
Looks like Lexi stayed there a little too long.
Camping out just a little too much. I think I saw a little s'more action going on down there, Bill, in the lane.
Well, if they build
a
campfire, you know they're probably going to call it.
Yeah. And Saints back in there 2-3. Coach Corey stayed with it all game.
Mm-hmm. Driving to the basket, hard shot, didn't go.
Faith Owen on the rebound, getting herself squared away, and number 9 giving her fits there. That's McKenna Van Mooyen.
They play hard, the Pilots do.
Talked with McKenna a little bit before the game. She's from Abbotsford. Abbotsford's in the Vancouver area.
And that you've been to Vancouver.
I lived just north of Vancouver, Bill. Hmm. A place called Squamish.
Squamish.
Squamish, British Columbia. Spent 2 wonderful years up there. And Abbotsford is right on the border with Bellingham, Washington.
Nice.
And so a lot of friends down in the Abbotsford area, actually.
That's a pretty good distance from old Moberly, Missouri.
It is. Akari at the line.
Yeah, Mac nails that free throw as no trouble. Saints are kind of pulling away a little bit in this third quarter.
Once they stop the three-point rain shower, we've been able to.
They're launching again. And
didn't you know it?
Maybe it's back.
It's drizzling again. Faith Owen on the press break, getting it up.
Good.
He got
good.
A 1-on-2.
There's a pass. Lexi's, that's a shot. Nice.
Another quick bucket off the press break for the Saints. 54-47. 2:40 as we wind down this third quarter.
Gonna shoot that three.
Another three up.
This one's off.
And that's going to be Saints basketball. Lexi took an elbow to the head from, that would be number two, Jackie Penner. And no foul called. Yeah. Half timeout called.
We're going to get a timeout, though.
We have everybody in the bonus right now. 54-47. Been a kind of a herky-jerky third period here, Bill, with a lot of the fouls and the referee menu discussions. Mm. And
well, it's been they've been playing hard, and they called a little bit more this quarter. They called some of those hands, and
that's a good observation from one half to the nother. They've been a lot tighter here in the second half.
Neither team's been able to get into a good rhythm on the offense, but the Saints are doing a good job breaking the press and getting some easy baskets.
Getting a lot of easy baskets here off the press. They're starting to feel comfortable and confident in how to break it and move it. And I think Coach Corey's gone with a particular lineup here a lot in the second half that has Kelsey Todd, Faith Owen, and Mercari, all of our ball handlers out there.
All those ball handlers are going to get that press broken.
Yep.
That's a shot Lexi makes. This one's a little off. That's a good shot.
Rebounded by the Pilots. Ooh.
She almost took your step
almost
there,
took
Brian.
That step.
She
yep.
almost took your step.
Yep. 10 with
left
the
that
shot
a little
off
short.
The dribble. Mekaria Hines.
Little Mekaria Hines, smallest one on the court with
Mack
the rebound.
Gets the ball up to Lexi. Lexi on her left-hand side.
And two.
Another layup for the Saints. 56-47.
Largest lead for the Saints.
Saints pull ahead by 9.
Long three.
Lexi
good
with the
rebound.
Rebound.
Good box out.
Gets the ball to Faith on the wraparound curve. Blocks everybody out. Faith has got the
Kelsey
quickness Todd's and the speed
in
to
the
go
corner.
In.
She ticked that. Kelsey's going to drive. And
good. Gets the shooter's roll. Faith is back up after the
rainbow from the lane. Faith looked like she might be hurt.
Yeah, she looked like she got banged up there a little bit. Knee knocked.
Long three. In and out. And we got a jump ball. Going to the Saints.
Saints ball leading by 11 now.
And we're bringing in 8 new players.
That would be 5 on one side, 3 on another.
That's right. Correct. That's great. Not all from the same team. Not all from the same team.
Minute 13 here. Saints lead by 11. Coming down to the end of this third quarter.
Been a good quarter for the Saints. Good quarter. Macy was in against the break down to Shelby Kinnamore.
Yep.
Good hands by the Pilots there. She took that little step. And
that's another turnover. That would be on Jasmine Horwood, a 5'8 first-year student out of Brandon, Manitoba.
Referee says you can't do that.
These are the Hansey sisters,
number
1 and number 5 there.
they do like to get after it.
Ball Rhea goes Brady. Into Rhea. Kelsey Todd gets it, drives into the lane, kicks it over to
that was to Rachel Darling.
Rachel Darling, and just a little high.
Just a little high. That looked like a basket if it could have been snagged there.
Here
long
they come.
3. Off the glass. And that's going to go
out of bounds.
They are playing hard down there. She dove right into the second row. Mekaria Hines is in for Macy and 5 new Pilots. Less than a minute to go, Brian.
I think that's isn't that a modern rock group?
Five new Pilots? Probably so.
No, sorry, it was Stone Temple Pilots, I believe is what that was. So, but 5 new Pilots could be, or new 5 Pilots, either way. Could.
Well, if it's not Michael W. Smith or Amy Grant, I don't know.
You don't know?
Okay. I don't know.
Fair enough, Bill. Some of us grew up outside the church for a little bit. And
that's true.
Well, have a few different influences, I think.
I like Chicago. Write that down.
Well, you're old, Bill.
Well, yes, I am old. That's coming across. That's going to be a long three. Pilots have grown a little cold from the three-point land.
They have not found the consistency that they did earlier in the quarter, that's for sure. 58-47, less than 10. Kelsey Todd on the drive.
Oh, that's a spin move. It's a beautiful move, but no reward at the end. Nice scrapping down there for Rachel. And the quarter ends.
A little ping pong action to end this third quarter. You're watching Saints basketball here from the 4-0 Center at Central Christian College of the Bible, where we have just finished the third period. Saints lead 58-47. Come back for the last quarter of this jam-packed action game. We'll be back in just a moment. You're watching Central Basketball from Central Christian College of the Bible. And we're back for fourth quarter action from the 4-0 Center on Central Christian College of the Bible's campus. Saints are leading 58-47. Pilots get the ball to start this quarter. First shot up, no good. Rebound to the Pilots, another deep three.
That one missed.
Rachel Darlin fighting hard for it, knocked out by number 12. That would be Megan Wiebe.
I'm guessing they're going to press, Brian. What do you think?
I think the odds are ever in their favor of that happening, Bill.
I would agree.
Mac Hines with the ball, taking up the center of the court, gets the ball to Rachel Darling. Over to Rhea Brady.
Rhea's looking to make a good pass. Mac's all alone.
Deep three.
That's splashdown.
Mac, the assassin, Hines.
Nothing but net. Biggest lead of the night for the Saints.
At a 14-point deficit for the Pilots here.
Long three. They're crashing the board. She had a turn, but she brought it back out.
Yep, I think they're just looking for the three-point shots, Bill.
And they got one.
And they got one from number 12. That's Megan Wiebe. Fourth-year player for the Pilots out of Vita, Manitoba.
Good pass down to Shelby Kinnamore.
On the drive. Oh, bucket for Shelby Kinnamore.
Great drive down that way.
And Shelby's got a smile from ear to ear as she runs down the court.
That's a good play. Long three from the Pilots.
Rachel Darling on the run out defense. Shelby Kinnamore
on
the rebound.
Shelby got that rebound. Over to
Kelsey Todd. And they're off. 2-1. 2-on-1.
And Kelsey drives it down.
Kelsey takes it in. Oh, no good.
A lot of crashing on the boards there.
Richard Darling had a chance to rebound and getting back on defense here for the Saints.
That's a long look at a three there.
That was a deep, deep three.
And they're scrapping and pushing, but that one's going to the Saints.
Good effort in there by Emma Wiebe, a 6-foot first-year student out of Brandon, Manitoba. I'm wondering if Megan and Emma are not sisters, Bill.
I would say they could be.
When we met with the coaches before the game, they didn't give us the fact that they had sisters on the squad. So, could be.
I think they could be. Rough. Worked out.
Saints getting lucky there.
That's free throw. All good.
Lexi Wisenand. That's her wheelhouse right there. 15-point lead for the Saints. 65-50.
Lexi Dota Macaria
with the rebound. Get gets the ball out. Now they've got a
now
three
it's
on
a
one.
Two on one for sure. And they picked that one off. Good hustle by the Pilots. And that's open in the middle, but she passes it up for a long three.
And Mercari on the rebound.
That's like two straight rebounds for the smallest player on the floor.
Brady with the handoff to Mercaria Hines. Kicks the ball over to Macy Wisenan. Rhea got her hand on it.
Yeah,
just couldn't get it pulled in.
She's frustrated with herself at that one, but it's good hustle. New set of Pilots in.
Five new Pilots.
And looks like Kelsey Todd's coming in for Mercaria Hines.
Deep three. Up, and that's going to be. Yeah. Oh!
Interesting.
No way.
Interesting.
No idea how he was a Saint even got a hand on that ball.
He was closer than we are. That's all I'm going to say about that.
What are you saying, Bill?
Just that. A good board. Another long three for the Pilots. This is a good board by Macy. She's trapped there in the corner.
You know, the thing that they're doing really good is when we get possession, they're trapping it.
They run two to the ball quickly.
Yeah, yeah. And it's caused us a little grief tonight. For the most part, we've handled it well, but I think the scouting report, if he looked at last year's team, said – we probably should press these guys all game.
Right. I would think that was the scouting report, but it has not paid off tonight. The Saints have handled the ball pretty well.
Rachel,
that's going to be on Rachel. She might have led with the elbow on that one, Brian.
Yeah, I think there was some contact there, and I think that was a pretty good call.
That's
good
a
job,
good steal.
Faith Owens on the steal and recovery. Drives it down.
Saints don't need to hurry. Just need to get a good shot.
Wisenan to Wisenan.
And that's a good shot.
And that's a connection. 67-50. Saints continue to press their advantage.
This is going to go out to the top again. Well, we got a foul inside.
I think, yep, Faith on the reach in there.
We got another.
It would be her fourth personal foul. Team's second foul this quarter.
Here come eight new players, Brian, three and five.
I am wanting Coach Corey to match this one time. I'm looking for Coach Corey to go five on five here with the swap in,
we
swap
don't,
out.
She'll have to bring in a manager because we don't have five.
I don't care.
And we're having another holdup in the game.
I still want five on five on the switch out.
Brian, with all these waiting, it reminds me of waiting for the vote in Arizona. we have a lot of conferences here.
Nope, we're not talking politics, Bill. That is one of the absolute rules I told you before the game. No
I
politics.
I just said we're waiting for the vote. I didn't say anything about it.
This is a no political zone on the broadcast.
Well, I'm not talking politics. I'm just talking about waiting.
And we're back at action. Pilots with the ball. Faith on the top of the zone coverage.
That's a long three.
Kicking out, looking for the bank. It's not open.
Yeah, the Pilots have just grown cold from out there. That's a steal. That's a good move. And two. Number 11, nice play.
Good work on the press there. Got the ball to Shelby Kennemore's collecting it. The ball to Faith Owen. And I think Coach Corey.
Yeah, we got a timeout.
Called a timeout. A full timeout there. So we're going to take a break here. It's Saints leading the Pilots from Providence University College. They're leading by 15. 5:35 to go here in this fourth quarter. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back. You're watching Saints Basketball from Central Christian College of the Bible. back after that full timeout. Saints
had the ball.
We'll have the ball at their half of the court. Shelby Kennemore on the double team. It's a
ankle
pass and turnover.
Pilots are still playing
deep
hard.
Three. We've got Hannah Neese in the game for the first time for the Saints. Faith Owen with the ball, dribbling it up the court.
That's a long shot from Macy.
Macy Wisenan on the shot, and we're going to have a...
We got a foul.
Reach over on number 12. That's Megan Wiebe.
That's going to be...
Fourth-year player. Her second personal foul, second team foul. A lot of fewer fouls called this quarter.
This fourth quarter?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think they have swallowed the whistle some on in this quarter.
Faith gets the ball into Lexi Wisenan. She's on the drive.
I think, yeah.
Her and Hannah were fighting for the rebound, and ball goes back to the Pilots. Ball
good,
knocked
good
out
defense,
by Faith.
Long three. Nobody home. There's a rebound and
shot
back,
up
number
and
11.
Good for Claire Grisless.
Saints having a little trouble getting it in. And that one's going back to the Pilots.
One of the few times tonight the press is, they've just had less than a handful of turnovers on the
Yeah, they've done a good job breaking the press. They have done. But that time it just didn't work. Long three. And we got over the back.
That's Trinity Blair on the rebounding foul. Her fourth personal foul. We have a swap out wave again. Faith Owen to inbound the ball for the Saints. Gets the ball.
Aria and Kelsey are down there. Kelsey gets
Todd.
It. Maintains her dribble. Looks like she got Hannah in the middle there.
Saints doing a good job just getting things set up and avoiding the double team action put on by the Pilots. Number one getting.
Clock's winding down.
And. Little Mac
driving in amongst the trees.
Picks up the foul, draws the foul.
Gonna get two from the line.
That's fourth personal foul on Kishi Rio Ferrio.
Smooth free throw.
68-54. Saints lead with a second shot coming from Markaria Hines. Second one is good, 69-54.
Saints are looking good, leading by 15. Long range.
I tell you, Bill, I would like playing for this Providence coach.
You can shoot.
I just come down and shoot.
I mean.
And not just any shot, but three-pointers.
Yep. Well, I guess you don't make any shots you don't shoot. And the press worked again that time.
Yeah, they've cut the lead to 11 now. Saints having a hard time.
And they're going to turn that one over as well.
Three consecutive turnovers. And Coach Corey has no timeouts left.
No timeouts left.
69-58.
New set of Pilots in the game. And Flight of Pilots threw that to the coach.
That's a pass where nobody was home.
Well, that was a toss right to the coach. Saints will say thank you very much.
And give it right back.
And give it back.
Merry Christmas.
Spirit of giving.
Pilots with the ball. Drive into the lane.
Ooh.
That looked like a Euro step plus, Bill.
I thought so, too. And I thought that the Pilots might have been all over the rebounders there, but no call.
Lexi Wiseman coming in for Mac Hines.
I think that's Macy.
Macy, you're right.
She would not like to be called Lexi, I don't think.
No.
Good board by Hennemies. Good board.
Gets the ball. Several Saints.
And there's a kiss off the glass. Leads back up to 13.
Faith Owen with the rebound. Game's getting a good job of backing off and giving herself space to work.
Game's getting kind of fast here. Need to slow it down a little. Ooh.
Faith does a good job to go and get that ball. Deep shot from Kelsey Todd.
That's three.
Three more for Todd.
Leads back up to 16.
16. And another turnover.
And a turnover from the Pilots.
Saints are doing a good job of playing under control. You can easily get out of control with the press breaks and get frustrated with particularly the last few minutes of play here.
Well, they're not panicking. They're not getting hassled with the ball. They are making the plays they need to make.
Doing a good job of maintaining their composure and making passes. And
they're going to get fouls now. The rest of the way, we're going to see some free throws.
Yep. Minute 56. Kelsey Todd going to line for the Saints. Kelsey's one of the more natural ball handlers I've seen.
Mm-hmm.
In our league. She just
freshman.
She and both Faith Owens both are have done a good job in their life of learning the skill of dribbling and controlling the basketball.
And making good passes.
It's fun to watch them play that way for sure.
Good free throw. And that's Rhea Brady with the rebound. Good hustle by Hannah Neese, and that one's going to go to the Pilots, but good hustle by the Saints.
Rhea Brady a little frustrated. She couldn't get her hands on that rebound. Hannah Neese out. Oh, we got some traveling action there.
And
nothing called.
No,
Rhea Brady gets
goes
the ball
to
out.
The hoop. Saints got to break it. Got to get it in.
Shelby Kenmore gets it over to Faith.
Faith Owen down
Faith Owen
to Kelsey Todd.
Kelsey Todd with the spinning dribble, and we're going to have
a kick. We're
going
to have a kickball. That's going to go back to the Pilots.
Yep. Coach Corey asking.
That's a long three.
75-60, Saints lead by 15, minute 24 to go in this contest. Pilots have five team fouls, and Saints have two. Saints are out of timeouts.
Looks to me like, Brian, the Saints are going to get their third win of the season. That would be three in a row.
The girls are on a streak here.
That's dribbled off the foot of number two.
Yep. Kelsey Todd with the ball. Ooh, just a
good hustle. Good hustle.
hustle to get the ball back for the Saints. Faith Owen.
Faith Owen handling the ball well. Don't need to shoot. Just pull it out. Run that clock down.
Get the shot clock
up. Oh, we got a foul.
Hannah Neese going to the
line.
Going
to the line.
Hannah, 6'1 center out of Ellsbury, Missouri.
Freshman.
In her first year with the Saints. Up, no good.
Left that a little short. She'll hit the second one, Brian. I got a good feeling.
Okay, Nostradamus.
That'd be Thomas.
Oh, Nostradamus.
Yeah. Oh, I was wrong. A long three.
Hey, Brady on the rebound there. And
the Pilots are playing tough still.
And
under
Saints
a minute left.
Going to get the ball with 38.6 seconds left to go. Continue to lead by 15.
And they're still going
to
press.
Rachel Darling. Darling to Wisnan. Wisnan to Hines. Hines holding on to it at the top of the key. Gets the ball to Brady.
Brady.
Brady. And Hines.
Hines can't foul here.
A little loop-de-doo in by Megan Wiebe. Another turnover by the Saints. And we're going to have a foul called on the floor. That's only the third team foul, so nobody's shooting on this. Pilots will keep the ball underneath their own basket. 14.4 seconds to go. Saints lead by 13.
Pilots have it in the corner. Long three again. Splash.
And that's Megan Wiebe with the last 5 points for the Pilots.
They don't have to get it back down, and they...
Saints with another turnover.
Uncharacteristic of tonight, though. That hasn't been the norm.
Yeah. They've had streaks where they've had a hard time, Bill. But by and large, they've done a good job of handling the pressure.
This will do it right here, Brian.
And last shot is up,
no
and
good.
No good. There you have it. Your Saints, 75-65, 10-point win for the ladies tonight.
Great job by the Saints. Good hustle, way to break the press, good passing. Solid job.
We continue to see growth and development out of this very young team, Bill, and it's fun to see them come out with a hard-fought victory here tonight against the Pilots that come to us all the way from Otterburn, Manitoba.
That's a long way to travel, and they played hard as well.
We are grateful for their presence on our campus, even more grateful for the fact that our brothers and sisters in Christ aren't bound by borders and are carrying on the Lord's work just north of us here, and grateful for each and every one of them as they're preparing and training for some participation in the kingdom. So
absolutely. That's what it's all about in the big picture. So congratulations to them, and good luck in their game tomorrow at Calvary.
Yep. We wish them all the best. Safe travels. We understand they had 8 inches of snow last night in Manitoba, and so
they're probably glad they're further south.
They're enjoying the tropics here in Missouri.
But for the Saints, that's three straight, Brian. That's going to build some confidence in those young ladies.
So you've been watching Saints basketball from Central Christian College of the Bible. Thanks for joining us tonight. We'll be back in just a few minutes for our second of our doubleheader with the men's game. Thanks for watching Saints basketball.